Hi, how you doing there? Welcome to the show. My apologies for the hiatus, but it wasn't permanent because we are back with another video for your viewing pleasure. I'm Jeremy from The Leg Kick, and let's get into this week in boxing. For our first headline, let's talk about Floyd Mayweather versus Logan Paul. On the 7th of June, Floyd Mayweather, arguably the best boxer in the last 25 years, competed in an exhibition against Logan Paul, who is a YouTuber. The fight was not scored, but I believe there was a Twitter poll deciding the winner by public opinion. I did not see the Twitter poll, but if you watched the fight, you clearly saw Floyd dominated based on points. Based on public outrage, it seems that Floyd Mayweather was expected to knock Logan Paul out, which he did not, and that was that. Logan Paul got to walk away saying he went 8 rounds with the sport's best, and Floyd basically beat up on a YouTuber for 8 rounds. My takeaways from this fight: does this hurt Floyd Mayweather's legacy? I'm gonna say no. One freak show exhibition does not erase the impeccable professional boxing career of Floyd Money Mayweather. But he didn't knock him out, and if he would have knocked him out, he would not be getting any more credit than he is now for embarrassing him on points. So I see how this is a lose-lose situation for Floyd. But I also see why the public is upset that Floyd did not produce a spectacle for their hard-earned money. Personally, I believe the clamoring for the knockout had more to do with Logan Paul than it did with Floyd Mayweather. The Paul brothers have built their name up to where they have become public enemy number one to the fight fan community and also a segment of pop culture. People do not want to believe with all their heart that these guys are actually fighters, and they're waiting for someone, anyone, to end this charade once and for all. So when this fight was booked, they said, finally, somebody who can expose Logan Paul and vicariously expose Jake Paul in the process. But bringing the attention back to Floyd, this was just a payday for Floyd. And even if Floyd was trying to stop Logan Paul, Floyd's legacy isn't affected by this because Floyd's legacy isn't built on knocking guys out who are his own size, especially a gentleman who's much larger than him. Assessing Logan Paul, I was impressed. I was impressed with his boxing ability, the ring IQ, and the tactic that he used to survive in that ring. He deserves a lot of credit for making good account of himself, and not to mention he got to the bag. Lastly, do I see celebrity boxing going away anytime soon? I'm gonna say no. I think celebrity boxing is here to stay, and personally, I have no issues with it because these fights are not meant to entertain the genuine boxing fan, but they do have the potential to bring new fans to the sport. A trend that I noticed amongst hardcore boxing fans is that there was little to no interest in this fight. Speaking personally for myself, I checked out when I seen that there was no winner being announced. I want to give a big shout out to Luis Arias, who pulled the upset against Jared Hurd. Even though it was a split decision instead of what should have been a unanimous decision, the judges got it right nonetheless. And this is a good thing that this pro fight was seen in front of millions in one of the highest grossing pay-per-views ever. For our next topic, on Saturday, June 12th, Shakur Stevenson pitched the shutout against Jeremiah Nakatila. I expected Shakur Stevenson to knock Nakatila out around the 8th round, just because Nakatila is a wild puncher who tends to not be very defensively responsible. But in this fight, he was a lot more defensively responsible than I've seen him in his previous bouts. But he only landed 11% of his punches, so maybe it was a little too defensively responsible. Shakur Stevenson, as always, displayed exceptional defense. Shakur would like to fight Oscar Valdez next, but it seems to me that Valdez would like to earn a bigger payday before he takes the risk of fighting a Shakur Stevenson. Next on our topic board, Naoya Inoue will be fighting Michael Dos Marianas on Saturday, June 19th in Las Vegas, Nevada. Inoue is ranked number 2 by The Ring magazine as the pound-for-pound best fighter right after Canelo Alvarez, and will be putting his IBF and WBA bantamweight world titles on the line in this fight. I don't know much about Das Marianas, but he is the IBF mandatory and is ranked number 8 by the WBA. I predict an easy victory for NUA. Quick storylines I want to throw your guys' way. On June 19th, WBC middleweight champion Jermall Charlo will fight Juan Marquez Montiel in Houston, Texas on Showtime. Teofimo Lopez contracted the coronavirus, and his fight with George Kambosos has been rescheduled for August 14th. I want to give a big congratulations to Clarissa Shields for getting the victory against Brittany Elkin in her MMA debut. And congrats to Daniel Dubois for knocking out Bogdan Dinu in the second round of their heavyweight bout. Well, that's all for now. You know what to do. Please comment on anything you heard today. Remember to jab that like and subscribe button. This is Jeremy saying sayonara. Thank you for stopping by. Thank you for listening as always. And see you next week.